I'm Adi Iyer, and this is a PNI Minute. Cavernomas are abnormalities of blood vessels in the brain. They tend to be venous in nature, and collections of veins that are shaped almost like little mulberries that can form throughout the brain and spinal cord. You know, oftentimes these can be completely silent and patients don't know they have them. Every now and then they can bleed. If they bleed, that can present as a headache, stroke-like symptoms, or even seizures. Cavernomas can be basically anywhere in the brain and spinal cord or brainstem. So the location of the cavernoma really determines the symptoms that they can have. Even though the bleeds tend to not be very devastating, if it's in a critical location, that can cause severe disability to the patient. There's a subpopulation of cavernomas that are genetic. So if you have a strong family history of cavernomas, Hispanic patients tend to have a higher rate of cavernomas as well. Patients that may be having seizures, headaches, neurological deficits should be worked up with an MRI scan to determine whether they have a cavernoma. The majority of cavernomas don't need to be treated and they can be followed with imaging. If the cavernomas are really causing problems, they can be treated with surgical resection and microsurgery. If it's an easily accessible cavernoma, patients may often go home the next day. If it's a difficult cavernoma that may require a longer hospital stay and more rehabilitation, those tend to be in the brainstem. Surgery for cavernoma involves removing a small window of bone and then using a neuronavigation system and a microscope to precisely find exactly the location of the cavernoma. And then we use a CO2 laser to resect the cavernoma in one whole piece. Again, at PNI, we can work up patients with cavernomas thoroughly. We can do a full neurological examination, get the appropriate imaging studies, and we have all the resources and technology here to do safe and effective surgery for them. The majority of cavernomas patients are born with, but they can develop later over time as well, so they can be in both younger and elderly patients. A 1 in 200 Americans will have a cavernoma. Now, the first question is, do I need to be treated for this? Oftentimes the answer is no, and if they're having significant symptoms, what is the treatment, which tends to be surgery. Radiation or radiosurgery tends to not work for these, and then what's the recovery time? There's some new data coming out about using beta blocker medications for cavernomas, which is really promising. So over time, this may become a medically managed disease.